This is an original three-sheet poster from 1912, an astonishing lithograph that depicts the descent from the cross. For a silent movie called The Life of Christ, this poster was in poor condition, creased, folded, with paper loss. Watch how it went from this to this. Hello, I'm Chris, and welcome to a new installment of Poster Fix Studio. When this poster came to us, I noticed as I opened it up that the creases were heavy, but the poster, miraculously, was not faded. I looked at it and thought about why. It occurred to me that this poster, after its initial use in 1912, was probably put away into storage and was kept in the dark, thereby protecting it from exposure to dirty air, moisture, or light. But the three sheets are glued together and must be separated before it is linen-backed. I'm now mixing the wheat paste so that I can linen-back the poster. The linen-backing will flatten the poster and provide a base from which I can do further restoration and paper fills. Linen backing is a way of mounting a poster to acid-free paper and cotton canvas. This helps the poster get stronger so that it will last longer. Prepare this big screen to mount the poster on. This is acid-free paper being mounted to canvas. And after that's done, we will mount the canvas. After that's done, we will mount the poster to this paper. And then they'll all dry together. And now we're going to have a message from our advertisers. When we come back, you will see the linen backing of this poster. So don't go away. Welcome back to Poster Fix Studio. Now we are going to linen back this poster. Because of its fragility, I have a tendency to want to put the wheat paste directly onto the acid-free paper and then lay down the poster dry onto the wheat paste. This is a safer method with very fragile posters. We disattached the three sheets and are laying them down individually to help ensure that they will expand properly. The Life of Christ is known under a few other titles, such as Manger to the Cross and Jesus of Nazareth. It is an account of the life of Jesus Christ based on the books of the New Testament. After Jesus' birth is foretold to his parents, he is born in Bethlehem and visited by shepherds and wise men. After a stay in Egypt to avoid King Herod, his family settles in Nazareth. After years of preparation, Jesus gathers together a group of disciples and then begins to speak publicly and to perform miracles, inspiring hope in many of his listeners, but also arousing some dangerous opposition.
Screen.
This was a silent movie about the life of Christ. The director was Sidney Olcott. The writer of the scenario was Jean Gontier. It starred R. Henderson Bland, played Jesus the man, and Percy Dyer played Jesus as a youth. Jean Gautier was Mary. She also wrote the screenplay as well as playing Mary. Alice Hollister, Mary Magdalene. Samuel Morgan was Pilate. James D. Ainslie, John the Baptist. Robert Vignola was Judas. You can look this up on IMDb, the Internet Movie Database. This movie is perhaps the first major effort on celluloid about the life of Christ, but being virtually a century old or more, cinematic technique was obviously very primitive then. Through the static camera work makes the whole feel more like a succession of religious tableaus than a film. Framing is generally pretty crammed and sometimes even offers admirable depth for its era. While obviously recounting events which would be familiar to most viewers, this aims for absolute authenticity. Not only is the entire script composed of direct quotes from the scriptures, but the filmmakers even went so far as to shoot in the actual Palestinian locations. In the early days of lithography, oftentimes the artist himself made the plates, did the artwork on the plates, and made the color combinations himself. As time went on in the printing field, standards and practices separated the duties of the lithographer from that of the artist. So it's hard to know with many of these posters whether the artist himself did the plates or whether a lithographer did them. Most likely, a union lithographer interpreted the artwork onto the plates. The Hays Code. When people talk about the more innocent Hollywood of years gone by, they're referring to an era when the movie industry policed itself. Depictions of Jesus Christ are rare in movie posters, especially from this era. Generally speaking, there was a tendency to avoid depicting God in movies. Since this movie dates from 1912, there were no codes, no laws, nothing restricting filmmakers' presentations of God. However, this poster does follow Catholic canon in that the image is basically based on the same visual language that you would get in masterpieces of the past, such as The Descent from the Cross by Peter Paul Rubens or by Rembrandt. In the history of Christian art, The Descent from the Cross has been depicted many times by many masters. In fact, I could even say that much of graphic design owes its mojo to the history of Christian art, even dating back before Christian art, obviously, to Roman and Greek art, Egyptian art. But certainly the Catholic Church made a big contribution to graphic design with stained glass windows, fresco painting, as in those of the Sistine Chapel in Rome, utilizing great artists like Caravaggio, Raphael, Michelangelo, and the like. Where would humanity be without them? This piece has broken down the center like the first piece did because we found additional breaks in the paper that were being held together by invisible tape, which we did not see until the last minute.
company is coming to get you.
Don't go away. When we return, you'll see the completion of the linen backing of this poster. The poster has been drying for a few days, and now I want to go in and burnish it to make it flatter and to start the process of putting the paper fills into the poster. I take a burnisher and I gently apply pressure where the fold creases are high, and this gets them to go flat, or to become flatter than they were, if not totally flat. Now I'm going to start the process of putting paper fills into the edges and into the areas of the poster that need paper fills. I'm basically using paper pulp, which is a mixture of paper powder, acid-free, mixed with a secret ingredient to make it stick. When it dries, it's basically paper, except it fills in the hole the way I want it to. After this commercial break, you will see the finale and completion of the restoration of this vintage poster for the life of Christ. Don't go away. We'll be right back. The color you see my wife mixing now with gouache is meant to match the color of the old white paper of the border so that we can match the paper fill area with the rest of the poster. In these difficult times we're living in, it would be good to be reminded that God is with us. It's safe to say that this poster has been restored through the process of linen backing at Posterfix. I do appreciate the opportunity to restore this historic article depicting the descent of the cross for the movie The Life of Christ. I look forward to seeing what posters you're going to send me. Thank you for joining me today. Until next time, so long from Posterfix Studios. Posterfix, where we bring your vintage posters back to life.